The month of Ramadan has many wisdoms. And from amongst the wisdoms of Ramadan, number one, is fasting reminds us of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, it reminds us of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as food and drink. And sometimes we take this for granted. But when someone does not have food and water, it reminds him, subhanallah, that the blessing which he's deprived of for a certain short time, you know, 12 hours, 10 hours, after that he will get food on his plate. In fact, he'll have excellent food, beautiful food on the table. Samosas and bajia and pakora and burgers and kebabs and subhanallah, rice and biryani and all sorts. So when he does not have food, he's feeling the thirst, he's feeling the hunger. This reminds him of the blessing which Allah has given to him on a daily basis, food and water. This is a great blessing, a great wisdom of Ramadan, that he reminds him of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will obviously make him remind him of other blessings. Yes, that just like he's remembering this blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will remind him of the other blessing which Allah has blessed him. His eyes, his nose, his tongue, his ears, hands, subhanallah. These are all blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, fasting brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by making us grateful. Yes, by restricting a blessing, then we appreciate this more. Therefore, we get closer to Allah. We are appreciative to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are more grateful to Allah. La in shakartum la azidannakum. That if you do shukr, Allah is saying, if you do shukr, I will give you more. So this is developed in the month of Ramadan. And number three, fasting decreases desire. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ said to the youngsters, Ya ma'ashara al-shabab, man istata'a minkum al-ba'a, falyatazawwaj. That, oh group of youngsters, if you have the ability, physically, financially, in all ways, if you have the ability of getting married, then you should do so. This will protect your eyesight. This will protect your gaze. It will protect your chastity. So when someone is fasting, it decreases, it kills the desires. Number four, people, they attend the masjid more frequently. Subhanallah, tarabih salah. And other salah, during the day, people attend the salah more. We see the masjids are full. We come for dhuhr salah on a normal day, outside the month of Ramadan, two safs, three safs. But someone who, when you come in the month of Ramadan, subhanallah, masjid is full, all floors full. Two floors, three floors, all of them are full, subhanallah. And number five, we begin to pray the salah on time. Some brothers don't pray, some sisters don't pray. But Ramadan has this attachment, this magnet, that it connects you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he starts to, and she starts to pray the salah on time. Five times a day, he and she starts to pray this. Number six, brotherhood increases. Yes, we see each other regularly. Yes, we see them in the masjid, we see brothers in the masjid, we see brothers in iftar parties, families get together, unity. This is one of the wisdoms of Ramadan, unity. That some brothers, you have some family members, brothers, you haven't seen. Ramadan connects everyone together. It brings everyone together. Number seven, all of us are attached with the Quran. Subhanallah. Even if it's not reading, some individuals can't read. But the attachment will be Tarawih Salah. They have this attachment. I want to listen to the Quran. I want to attend the Tarawih Salah so I can listen to the beautiful words of Allah Ta'ala. This is obviously listening, but for those who can read, subhanallah, you'll see the masjid full, everyone's reciting Quran. The Huffaz will be reciting the Quran on a daily basis. They'll be revising the Quran. And this is a huge wisdom of the month of Ramadan. Number eight, we increase in our charity. Subhanallah, brothers give when they enter in the masjid, placing money, whether it's 10p or £1 or £2, they place money in the box. Subhanallah. Why? Because of the greatness of Ramadan, that their hearts go soft. The fasting makes their hearts go soft and they start to give more charity. Number nine, we increase in our dua. You see, in the month of Ramadan, iftar time, suhoor time, during the day, after salah, we're always making dua. And dua is increased in the month of Ramadan. And last but not least, gives us the realization that we could be better Muslims. Because when someone is attached to the masjid, when someone is attached to Quran, he now thinks, look, subhanallah, I need to read more Quran. I've come for salah, I need to continue after month of Ramadan. Someone who, when he comes to the masjid, there will be lectures in the masjid after Asr salah, after Fajr salah, or any other salah. And this will make him think, look, I need to acquire knowledge. So this will make him realize, subhanAllah, I need to rectify my life. I need to become a better Muslim. These are just some of the wisdoms of the month of Ramadan.